Hey guys, you're Marty Geek. In this video, I have an awesome unboxing of the Xbox One X Cyberpunk 2077 Limited Edition console. This console just came out and I received it yesterday. Of course, I bought it. Right now, you could get it for around $299. And that includes the game, which you're gonna get via digital download. It's a reason why I pulled the trigger and bought it, because you're basically getting the console for less than $250. Keep in mind, the game by itself is $60, right? So you're basically getting the Xbox One X, which is the 4K model, great power, for only around $250 or $40. So I didn't hesitate when this came out and bought it, because there's going to be just a limited quantity of them. And also keep in mind, this is the last Xbox One limited edition console or customized console that Xbox is going to be releasing. After that, whatever customized Xbox console you get is going to be a Series X, which is the next generation of consoles. But this is the last one. It looks beautiful. Since day one, since I saw it, I said I want it. Honestly, I thought the price was going to be a lot more than $399. And when I saw it was $299, I just pulled the trigger and bought it. And I am super happy. And now is the first time I ever going to unbox it. So here we are doing it on video so you guys can enjoy. The game itself is actually supposed to come out September 17th. So that's awesome. Would be nice if we actually get to play the games from now on. But that's not the case. So here, of course, you only got the character, which is awesome. You got a picture of the controller, which was already available. You got the console right there. And of course, you got the little cover of the game that's going to be available there. Like, see right there. So you got the cover there. You got the controller, the console, and the game box that's going to be there. Here on the side, you have nothing. And over here, you got the same thing over again. And let's go ahead and take this out, because this is basically like a sleeve. Oh, and look at that. Yes, the inside box also is customized. Look at that. Nice. That is awesome. Okay, and on this side, oh, look at that. Oh man, this looks even better on this side. Oh, you got the console, the controller, 1 terabyte, Cyberpunk. You got like some graffitis there. Holy crap, that looks very, very beautiful. Yes, sirree. That looks really nice. Of course, here you got some information about the console. And over here, you got some picture about the console as well. And that's it. Wow, that looks pretty damn badass. So let's go ahead and take this out. Here, let's see what you got in this box. Okay, power cord, of course. You got, oh yes, you got the HDMI cable, which, look at the color. Let me know in the comments, is this customized as well for the console, or does every Xbox One console comes with this? Because keep in mind, I don't have, right now at this moment, I don't own an Xbox One X or Xbox One S. I've been playing Xbox games on my PC thanks to Xbox Game Pass. But this, really cool if this is actually customized. And here, whoa, this controller feels heavier than the one that I have. This is the controller. Oh, and that's because it comes with battery. Oh my. This is the first time that I'm actually looking at this. I'm gonna put this to the side. This is the first time that I'm actually looking at this controller in my hands. Oh my God, it looks beautiful. It's all scuffed. Like, see, that says no future. Oh wow, look at that. Rig XT7 Pro. Arasaka. Wow, look at that. Awesome. And I think it comes with the batteries as well. Let me see. Yep. Yes, sirree. Comes with the battery as well. So we're gonna go ahead and take this out. Okay, there you have it. And let's see if this thing turns on. Yep, it does turn on. There's nothing actually special about the little light right there. You know, there's no other light turning on anywhere. But that looks really damn beautiful. Oh man, I love the two-tone color. Looks damn gorgeous. We got this, which includes, I believe it's the Cyberpunk game, Xbox One Pass, and Xbox One X. Let's see if this is actually the code. In this paperwork right here in the back, it actually says that the game is going to be automatically downloaded to my console when the game comes out without even entering a code whatsoever. So for having the console just connected to the internet, when the game comes out, it's going to be available to download automatically. And the cool thing is that not only are you getting the game with the console, when the Xbox Series X comes out, and there you're going to get the Xbox Series X, the next gen version, for free as well, because we got smart delivery with this game. So that's the cool thing about it, that if you like the game and you want to keep playing it when the next gen comes out, you're still going to be able to play it because of the smart delivery. Keep in mind, it also comes with a month of Xbox Game Pass Ultimate as well. Here, let's see. Here you got, I believe, it says Samurai right there. Awesome. Beautiful. What the hell is this supposed to be? Oh, wait a second. This is supposed to be the stand. And it comes in this huge box. Why does it come in this huge box? We got the stand for the console right here in a huge box that says Samurai and nothing else. And now we have the console. Just gonna take this baby out. Nothing more there to see. Just gonna put this to the back. And here we have it. Wow, it's a little bit heavy and so tiny footprint. Look how tiny that console is. Oh my. Oh yes. Look at that. Holy crap. Look how beautiful that looks. If you use it vertically, that's how it's gonna look. Wow, this thing is small, but it's heavy as hell. So here you got Xbox One, Xbox. You got these numbers right there, and letters and writing. Wow, 313. I don't know if this is the 313 console that I have, because remember, that's gonna be, I think, around 40,000, I think, of these available. Here you got some more writing. Looks beautiful. Here's the front. Oh my, look at that. Xbox button right there. Wow. Nice. Damn, that looks pretty damn awesome. Strong magnetic field. Hoo hoo hoo. Here on the side, this is how it looks. This is where the stand, I believe, is gonna be hooked up right there. Here in the back, look at that. Awesome, beautiful. Power, HDMI out, HDMI in, USB-A, USB-A, IR out, optical audio, and Ethernet. Nice. And of course here, just looks like that. Ventilation in the back. Oh, look at that. No future, has like a devil face. Like one of those Chinese or Asian devil face. Look at that. Wow. That looks gorgeous. So let's go ahead and put this stand on. Okay, there you go. So it easily slides in there. That looks really, 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 really damn beautiful. So right now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna plug it into the power and turn it on and turn it off to see if there's any special sound and see if there's any other lights turning on. I already have it plugged into the power. So let's go ahead and see and listen if we get some special sound when you turn on the console. Let's go and do this right here. Oh, that was so cool. So you have this little light that turns on there. I believe that light is only available on this console. And of course, like, I don't know if you guys heard, but it did a sound like a robot turning on or something. Let's go ahead and see how it sounds when it turns off. Oh, nice. It's going to turn it on again. So let's see if there's any other lights that turn on. So around the console, like you see, there's no other light that is actually turning on whatsoever. These looks like lights, and this right here, but they're not actually real lights turning on. But I believe that the only lights that you're going to see are here in the front. And the sound also comes really cool from there. Nice. And turn on. I'm going to be setting up the console, see if there's anything more special about the console, especially the dashboard. If there's a difference when it comes to the dashboard compared to the original Xbox One X. Okay, so I decided to add this because most likely you want to know how the hell do you claim the game, right? And here it is. Once you set up your Xbox One X and you put all the things, you do the updates and all that, here you got the Xbox Game Pass Ultimate you can claim. Plus, you got the game as well that you can claim right here. So all you got to do right here and claim this, right? We claim that, which is the Ultimate Game Pass. There you go, I claimed that. Now let's go ahead and claim the game itself. The game itself. So it says this product is not intended for individual sale. Any pre-order or purchases for this product will be canceled and refunded. And of course you got the description of the game. Cyberpunk is an open world action adventures game, blah, 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 blah. Let's go ahead and claim it. So now, when the game finally comes out on September 17, I think it is, it's going to be available for download right away. There you go. You can access and manage this content on my games and apps. And that's it. The game is going to be tied to your account. I believe this is the look that the Xbox dashboard has had, right? Let me know in the comments. Because there was a rumor that the dashboard was going to get updated, and I don't know, but it seemed like something similar to this, but I don't think so. Let me know in the comments, is this your typical dashboard that you have right now on the Xbox One, or is this new? I think this is not new. I believe this is not new. Oh, look at that. Installation complete, 27.7. This game, obviously, I'm going to be playing on the Xbox One X. And I don't know, you know, I normally play at PlayStation 4 games a lot, but I guess the last PlayStation 4 game that I'm going to be playing is Ghost of Tsushima. After that, I'm going to be playing everything else on this console because I want to use it as much as I can before the Xbox Series X comes out. So I'm going to be using this console as much as I can. And I guess the last games that I'm going to be playing on the PlayStation 4, I could tell you right now, it's going to be Last of Us 2 and Ghost of Tsushima. Those are the two last games I'm going to be playing ever on my PlayStation 4. And, you know, everything else is going to be played here until the next generation comes out. And that's it. So, you know, there you have it, guys. Thanks for watching this video. Let me know what you think about this console. Do you like it or not? What you think about it? Thanks for watching, guys. Till next time. Bye-bye.